Hey, this is PJ with CLK Supplies, and we are doing a key programming battle today. We're gonna be putting up the AutoProPAD up against the Smart Pro, and we're gonna see which one on this particular vehicle does a better job. I'm personally rooting for both of them, but you know what? Let's find out and see. Now, this is a 2017 Toyota Camry that we're gonna be adding keys to today, and the transponder key we're gonna be using is the TOY44H. Now, it's freezing cold out here right now. I mean, I'm dreaming of putting my hands on my steering wheel warmer in my truck, but until then, I'm gonna have to tough it out, okay? But it's so cold that when I opened up the vehicle just to check it out really quick, I noticed that the battery was like completely dead. So thankfully I had my jump box with me. I got it hooked up and we're ready to get to work and see who's gonna win this battle. Let's get started. All right, so we have the AutoProPAD connected to the OBD2 port and we're ready to get programming. We'll go up here to US Toyota. We'll hit agree to the disclaimer. And we'll go into immobilizer. Now, it's like I always tell you, it's really important to make sure you go to the AutoProPAD's website and look up the information here. It tells you everything that you need to know. It tells us it's a type 4 for this one. And, you know, just make sure you're looking at that before you actually get to the job so you're prepared. So we're going to go right here to the H, which this is an H chip, so that makes sense, the type 4. So we'll click on that. 2015 on, this is a 17, so that information matches as well. And it says failed to connect. So let me go ahead and put a key in and turn it to the on position here. Turn that down. Now let's give it a try here. Okay, so you know what? It went ahead and got us in here to this point, and we're ready to continue on. So we're going to go to add key. Okay, so it says a master key is needed to erase and to add keys. To identify a master key, okay, it's on ahead to identify it. So we know we have a master key right here. This is the original right here. So we're good there. But it lets you know, it says insert key into ignition if security light did not flash. It is a master. If it did flash for 1 second, turn off, then it's a valid A. So we already know this is a master, so we're good to go. So we're gonna hit yes. So insert programmed master key and switch ignition to the on position, okay? So I'm gonna take this key out here. I'm gonna take this master key, I'm gonna put it in, turn it to the on position, and click yes. Okay, insert the key you wish to program, and do not switch to the on position. Okay, so we have to make sure we're paying attention here. So we're gonna take this master key out, stick our new key in, do not turn on. I almost did there too, but we'll hit yes. Wait for security light to turn off and the programming is complete. Okay, so you can see the security light right here. So let's just wait, I'll be patient and we'll see what happens. Okay, so as you can see right here, it's not flashing anymore. So it looks like we're gonna be done here. So now it's not doing it, we'll click okay. Now, the big question is, does it start? Let's find out. Take a look at this security light here. We definitely don't wanna see anything coming on. All right, so that key is programmed. Let's try the master key just to be sure everything is still good. All right, so we have the Smart Pro connected to the OBD2 port and we are ready to get programming. We're going to go up here to vehicle selection. We'll go down to Toyota and then we'll go to Camry 2017. All right here, as you can see, 14 to 17, it shows, it says blade, and what that means is it's a, you know, keyblade, and it's not like a prox or something like that, so we'll go ahead and click it.
All right, now from here, it popped up as on remotes, actually. We're going to want to go over to a mobilizer. Now, when you get to the vehicle, or before you get to the vehicle, you always want to, you know, be looking on that My Keys Pro app. It's going to give you all the information, and you want to be prepared when you get to the vehicle. Now, I know I say this a lot, but it's just because it's super, super important. So now that we're here, we'll go ahead and hit the connect button. Switch ignition on. All right, it is. And we're going to go down here to Program Keys USA right there. And then we'll hit the play button. Okay, so this function is used to add keys only. At least one current master key is required. Now we still have that OEM key right here. And so we're going to be good there. So we'll hit OK. It says remove current key, insert working master key, and switch to on. So I'll put that in there, turn it to on. Gives us, you know, a little time lapse. So that's always nice to have there. We'll click OK. Okay, so switch ignition off, remove key within 20 seconds, and the security indicator light should be on. All right, so if you look over here, we're gonna see that there. But now we got to take our new key, put it in within 10 seconds, and keep it on the off position. I had to hurry there, sorry, but we had to hurry through that part. But we're doing that right now, and as you can see down here on the light, you know, the security indicator, it's flashing, and so we're just gonna wait until it's not. All right, so now it says security indicator should now be off, and if you look down here, you'll see it is off. So that's a really good sign. So we'll click OK. It says procedure is complete. Let's try to give it a start here. There we go. It started up without a problem. You can see the security indicator light is out, which is what we want. Now let's just go back. Let's try the master key one more time. It's always good practice just to be on the safe side, and we're all set. All right, so there you have it. Both the AutoProPAD and the Smart Pro got the job done. Now, as far as the AutoProPAD goes, it did, you know, it worked. It got the job done. The prompts, you know, left me guessing a little bit. However, if I were to do another one of these, you know, tomorrow, I would, you know, come to understand what's going on, right? So the important part, though, is that it got it done without any trouble, right? So I'm gonna give the AutoProPAD 4 out of 5 stars on this one. The only reason I'm not giving it a 5 is just because the prompts weren't as clear as they could have been. Now, as far as the Smart Pro goes, it had all the extra little prompts in there. You know, that user interface is really nice. You know, it's probably the best feature of the Smart Pro. And since it gave us all those extra steps and got it done, I'm gonna give the Smart Pro a 5 out of 5 stars. So at the end of the day, both of them got the job done. Both are good machines. The Smart Pro won this one, but the AutoProPAD did a great job. Let me know in the comments below what you think. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.
Since you just watched this video, I'm guessing that you work with locks and keys. And to us at CLK Supplies, that makes you a lock boss. And we wanna hook you up. Here's how it works. Throughout the week, join the conversation and comment on our posts and videos and include the hashtag LockBoss. It's free to enter this giveaway. And every Tuesday, we're gonna pick 5 winners from the previous week and hook you up with all sorts of prizes, including gear, tools, supplies. We might even send you a key machine or buy you lunch. So if you're a LockBoss, join us every week to learn, grow, and win.